look, some highlights for me, I guess, were certainly certainly the first trippers. So our first ever adventure fitters. We actually, so far out, man, going into Athena right now, going to my new company, I was like, okay, cool. This is how we need to structure things from the start. Drew had his ideas, I had my ideas, and we were both very, very thorough and very, very professional from the get-go. You know, I know a lot more than I did when I started AdventureFit, and I wanted to make sure I didn't make the same mistakes getting this business off the ground as I did with AdventureFit. And it's funny what happened with AdventureFit. So the first ever trip, I came up with the name Adventure Fit. I remember asking family and friends and so forth. I remember wanted to call it Camp Nomad. I wanted to call it Vagabond Tours. I wanted to call it a bunch of other shit names. And yeah, my family and friends, Adventure Fit was also one of the names. And I asked all my, I got a little bit of a focus group, and I asked them what they thought, and everybody came up with Adventure Fit. So I'm glad we set it on that name. We were actually able to sell the first trip out with just one graphic design poster, which was really cool. So I remember my mate Fletch did our first website, which still runs to this day, and people still give us compliments on it. He'd never done a website before in his life. He's a graphic designer. And he actually just knocked us up one poster, and he built our website, made us one poster, and we sold the trip out. We sold the trip out with the poster before the website, actually. But anyway, my point being on things that I've done wrong and things that I wouldn't do again, when we actually went to New Zealand, so I said, okay, cool, what's the first trip that I want to plan? You know, where do I want to start? Where do I want to make a big impact and go, right, bang, this is what we stand for. This is the trip that I want to put out there. This is going to be amazing. I wanted to do the absolute best case scenario, you know, experience I could possibly come up with. And the list of candidates were New Zealand was one, Canada was another, mind-blowing scenery. I haven't been there, but it looks beautiful. And Iceland was the other. And Iceland was way too far and way too hard. Canada was way too far and way too hard. And New Zealand was obviously right on our doorstep. So we decided to go to New Zealand, but yeah, the itinerary was great. We had 5 or 6 days on the North Island and 5 or 6 days on the South Island. But it was funny because I'd actually never been to New Zealand before in my life. So when we rolled up, I flew in on the, I think we started the trip on the 22nd of September 2016 or 17. 16, I think. 22nd of September. So I rolled in on the, I would have rolled in on the 20th, I reckon. I would have rolled in 2 days before the trip. Never been to New Zealand in my life. Never even seen any of the countryside. Not Auckland, not Queenstown, not Franz Josef Glacier. We were going glacier climbing. And I didn't have the money to do it. I didn't have the money to go, okay, cool, I'm going to go do a dry run of this trip, because one of the reasons that AdventureFit was an issue for me was I was always stressed for money. And I started AdventureFit with a bunch of debt. Normally you'd start money with funding, or, you know, savings at least, or, you know, maybe some funding, even from your family and friends. But I did the opposite. I started with debt. So I didn't have time to do the run around and check out New Zealand. So I just landed in the country and I said, fuck it. And we just toured people from north to south. And it was really quite funny because people would ask me on the trip, they're like, oh yeah, okay, Doc, so, you know, how many times have you been to New Zealand? And I would say, no, just same as you. I just arrived 2 days ago. And obviously you'd think that was a joke. People would laugh their heads off. And then I'd kind of go, and then just, you know, pretend like I was joking, but I actually wasn't. So yeah, I mean, New Zealand was unfathomable. It's the most beautiful country. I mean, for those of you guys that have seen Lord of the Rings, you know exactly what I'm talking about. But you know, the North Island of New Zealand is Waitomo Caves, this huge caving structure. Waitomo Caves, we did a tour in Waitomo Caves. For starters, we abseiled into the fucking cave. We abseiled in. It's like a 30-meter abseil through this tiny little hole in the darkness all the way down in the the cave opens up. You go through this tiny little keyhole, and then it just opens up, and you're in pitch black darkness, and you just you descend 30 meters into the, you know, the base of the cave. And then the adventure begins from there. So we got on a zip line through the darkness in the middle of a cave. We get off there, we go cliff jumping inside of a cave into the water. Then once we're in the water, we're in the darkness of this cave, and it's filled with glowworms. So not only do you have all these adventures inside of this cave, but it's filled with glowworms. These absolutely beautiful, looks like the fluorescence. What is it? Don't know what it's called. Bioluminescence in the bottom of the ocean. So like when you see at night that the ocean looks all sparkly and looks like it's got stars all through it, you know, that's bioluminescence, I believe. Maybe I'm making that up. Well, these glowworms look the same, but on the ceiling, you know. So these fluoro green, beautiful, like speckles all over the place. And it was really great. And I remember one of my favorite moments was... one of my favorite moments, we were going through the cave and everybody was talking. So what happened was, we were in these blow-up tubes, and just a regular tubing tube, like a car tire kind of thing. So our bums are in the tubes and your feet are wrapped around the friend, you know, your friend in front of you, and you've got your friend from behind, you know, you've got their legs and you're gripping onto them. So you've got this big caterpillar-like, you know, kind of floating, you know, tube train. So anyway, we were floating through the caves in New Zealand, and we got to a point where everyone was chatting away, everyone's, you know, throwing shade at each other, bantering back and forth and whatever. And then we got to this section of the cave where it was so intensely, intensely beautiful. It was un-frickin' believable. This huge, huge cavernous cave, and the ceiling was just bright, bright green with all these glowworms and basically shimmering in the night and sparkling. And it was so breathtaking that without any kind of, without any direction or without anybody saying, hey guys, let's take a minute, everybody just went pure, like dead silent, and just continued to float through the cave. And I think, yeah, it was one of those... it was one of those times where you're really like, oh man, that was a beautiful experience. And I wouldn't say that about much stuff, you know. I'm a pretty blokey bloke. But oh my God, man. It was so perfect. It was like, it was one of those experiences where we were all on the same page. We all knew exactly what to do at that perfect time, you know. It just went without saying that, okay, cool, I need to shut up and just take all this in. And... if you haven't done it before, if you have never made it to New Zealand and done the Waitomo Caves, I'm sure there's other cave systems all around the world that, you know, are similar, but Waitomo Caves in New Zealand is really world famous, and oh, man, for good reason. So we actually finished up in the cave, and then after we'd done the cave, after we'd done the glowworm part of the cave, then I can't remember what else we did. We did a bit of... kind of like, what do you call it? I don't know. It was like, it was just hardcore cave exploring. So we're climbing through little tiny cracks in the structure and opening up to the next section, and then, you know, down again and getting further and further and deeper into this cave. Pretty sketchy stuff. Like, not sketchy, but tell you what, New Zealand, they've got really lax OH&S rules, because in Australia, you'd never get away with half this shit. But in New Zealand, play on. So, but to finish the actual experience, we came up and out this, we climbed out and up a running waterfall. And it was great. So, you know, the New Zealand trip, as much as... So I went over there with my mate Wilbur, who was the first ever person that I said, hey, mate, can you come join me on a trip? I actually lied there. My mate was the first person I ever asked to join me on a trip. And he said, yes. He said, yep, I'll do it with you. And then something came up with Woz, and he couldn't do it. And then he never actually made it on a trip, which is a bit of a bummer. But so Wilbur jumped in. He was keen as mustard. As soon as I told him that he was pumped. So Wilbur came along with me, and so myself and Wilbur ran that trip. Wilbur had done a little bit of New Zealand, I'd done zero, and we just flunked our way through it. Real fake it till you make it stuff. But I would have to say that, you know, that trip was, it was one of the greatest experiences ever. Particularly for the clients. I think if we ever nailed a trip, that was the one, you know, like Japan very shortly after, like, oh my God, man, that was sick. And, you know, but the first AdventureFit trip was super, you know, super important, and we really hit it out of the park. It was actually, the reason I said it was the best experience for our clients, the reason I said that is because it was actually a terrible experience for me. I look back on it fondly. I look back on it really, really fondly. But I actually, man, I had the heaviest anxiety, and I fucking deserve it, really. Like, let's be honest, I'd had a lot of really great people that had put their trust in me to take them and give them the, you know, best in class experience of a lifetime. Some people that would book on this AdventureFit holiday, like one of our holidays, they would have not had a holiday in 5 years, you know, or they might have not, you know, they might have not been able to, they might have just gone through a divorce, or they might have been, you know, made redundant at work, or whatever it is. You know, they put their trust in us, and I took that really seriously. Shortly after the New Zealand trip, I realized, you know, you can't really get away with doing that stuff. So look, we nailed it. We absolutely nailed it, but probably didn't deserve to. And, you know, it was probably fair game for me, but man, that was probably the first time I ever had hectic anxiety. Real bad stuff, you know, like sitting around the table with, you know, 10 amazing people, myself and Wilbur, and everyone's just having fun, and maybe a couple of beers, or maybe not, maybe it's just a sober night, or sitting around at breakfast or whatever, and the banter going, you know, back and forth, and everyone's having a great time, and I just couldn't get out of my own head, and just couldn't get into it. I was like trapped in my head really, really, really badly, and you know, so that was a tough one for me. But oh man, it was a good trip though. Like it was unfathomable. So you know, the New Zealand trip was a real highlight for me.